Hi there, everybody. This week, I'm bringing you an awesome inspirational story of a New York boy coming back to El Salvador. So, everybody meet Kevin. How long have you been here in El Salvador?
Since September 2023.
Okay, and what's your impression since coming back?
The country is a lot safer. It's a lot more clean, and you could just enjoy it a lot more than you could before.
Mm-hmm. And what are you seeing, or what are you experiencing now as someone that's back in the country and the opportunities that are opening up?
Well, when I came first time as an adult in 2020, and things were a lot different back then. Things were a lot more dangerous, and there weren't many things you can do because you were pretty much limited to where you were born, like the town you were born in. You couldn't really leave that town. But today, you still have a lot of people, the original Salvadoran people who were born and raised here, who still own their lands or the houses that they have for the past 40 years. And the opportunity that I'm seeing is that there's a lot of people who are wanting to have a new life or a change of scenery. They might have a lot of bad memories from the homes or lands where they live right now. And so there's a lot of potential for real estate. There's a lot of potential to buy land, potential to build your own house, and just really to invest your dollar into a country that still accepts the same dollar and Bitcoin. So I saw all those things, and I thought it was a good opportunity for myself and my wife to move here and to make El Salvador like one of our hubs, a place where we can build our home now, and just expand from here within the country and outside the country as well.
Okay, but you were back in New York. You were like living the high life, living the gringo life.
Yeah.
And I mean, why? I mean, lots of people left New York during the pandemic.
Yeah.
But why moved instead of just going to Florida, instead of just going to Georgia or something like that? Why come? What was it about New York and where you guys were at in New York that made you kind of say, you know what, we gotta go?
That's a good question. Well, I was born in Brooklyn. My wife was born in the UK, but we met around end of 2022 or 2021. And by the time I was thinking about all this, it was around 28 or 2020. I sort of lived an okay life in New York. I had a successful career in real estate. And I had all the things the average American person would enjoy, all the material things, eating at good restaurants, traveling the world, having a nice car. But coming to El Salvador the first time in 2020, and of course the pandemic, and also the state of the US dollar along with Bitcoin, I just started to kind of put the pieces of the puzzle together. And I started to realize that El Salvador is going to be a country that's going to attract a lot of people very soon, not just the Salvadorians or people that have left the country and are not coming back, but because of the Bitcoin tender, legalizing Bitcoin, and us having the same currency as the United States and land being so cheap, I know that there's going to be a lot of people that see this opportunity if I see the opportunity. So I said, I'm going to go there now, sooner than later, before the prices get way too high, where they become unreasonably high, like a Florida or like a Utah, where prices were cheap maybe 10 years ago, now they're not anymore.
Yeah.
So I kind of saw that anywhere I would go in the United States would be the same thing. It would just be like a smaller version of New York, a smaller suburb. But El Salvador is just a shifting culture, and also having the opportunity to fly back and forth, I can just look at El Salvador like I could look at Utah or Colorado. It's the same distance on an airplane. And it's just a small switch of mindset. Another great thing about being in El Salvador is your cost of living is at a fraction of the cost. So we own our house. We actually built our house.
Okay, but here's the next factor. Yes, there's lots of opportunities, but you have a wife and a baby. And what about that side of the equation?
Okay, that's a good question as well. Well, like I said, I'm from New York. I'm from Brooklyn. I went to public school my entire life, from K to 12, public school, my whole life. And as an example, my high school, we had about two fights a day, every single day. So every single day, you had security guards running to a certain floor. It was four floors. And the school was pretty much built out like a prison. It was very similar to a prison. Even lunchtime, which gave us 45 minutes, was very similar to, and I've only found out this later when I watch movies that have prison scenes in it. Our cafeteria was pretty much the same layout as a prison. So, in other words, you're not really missing much if you're not going to a public school in the United States. If you're going to a private school or a charter school or anything of those means, I'm pretty sure you could afford the same thing here in El Salvador. Or you can do what we're doing. We're going to homeschool our child because we think that the parents picking the curriculum for the child, especially when you sort of have in mind what that child might want to do in the future, that might be a better choice. Like, I was highly academic during school, but like I said, I went to a school where the graduation rate was about 28%. So probably one out of every four kids were graduating. And if they were graduating, they weren't graduating with any knowledge. I went to college. I luckily got a scholarship because I played soccer. But when I got to college and I took a math class, which was my best subject, I didn't know what calculus was because I never took a calculus course in high school. And all of my 4 years of high school, I didn't take one calculus course, which is, you know, it's systematic. And I later found out that public schools in pretty bad neighborhoods are marginalized a lot. So to think or to say that the United States has a great education system is not true. I think the United States and the education realm falls ranked number 20, about so. So I think you taking charge of your own child's future and life through homeschooling, yeah, it might be a little bit more work, but I think it's worth it in the long run. I mean, that's what we've decided to do.
Okay, awesome. Okay, next question is, how are you going to make El Salvador a better place because your family is here?
That's a great question. So for our cost of living, so this business out here, CRB or Cargan, Raíces Buenas, which means good roots, but it's sort of a play on words, meaning real estate, would be our third business. We have two other businesses in the United States, in New York. One is a digital marketing firm and the other is a real estate brokerage, which is why I'm doing this here. So what we're doing here in El Salvador is real estate, but after building our own house here, we've actually also come to understand what the culture is like here, the work culture, and just the culture in general behind construction and just generally, just people. And so our business here is going to be one of the first construction real estate / businesses that is going to operate more like a United States startup, where we're going to treat the first employees like stakeholders, like shareholders, where we're going to give them a piece of the pie. So just for an example, if we build a property and it generates an X amount of profit, I'm going to share a percentage of that profit with my partners or with the early founders, the early founding team of the company. So besides bringing the new culture, the new workforce culture to the country, we do intend on building new type of real estate that is a lot more cost friendly and also just more aesthetically more pleasant than what we have here that people have actually just become accustomed to and just accept because it's the norm.
Cool. Okay, last question. What is your recommendation or what is your advice to any other Salvadorans that are thinking about coming back or planning to come back? From your experience, what do you wish you knew before you jumped?
That's a great question. Well, that's two questions in one.
Yeah.
Okay, what would I tell the Salvadoran? I would say buy something right now. Because every month, every year you wait to buy something, it gets more expensive. So not only are you battling inflation, you're battling the rising prices of properties here. And if you don't buy something here, someone from Brazil, someone from Canada, someone from the UK will buy the property that was probably pennies on the dollar when you could have bought it because you have family here. So I would say buy property now and think about it later. There's a good saying, I can't really remember right now, but I think it goes, some people say invest and wait, or wait and invest, right? A lot of people would say you should just wait and invest, but with El Salvador right now, you should invest and wait. Just put money in here as soon as you can, wherever you can, even if it's a 1 acre lot, half acre lot, whatever it is, I'm pretty sure your money there will outpace the inflation and even the S&P 500, which grows at a 5 or 6%. So you putting money in El Salvador will definitely, you will definitely thank yourself in the long run. And even if you're not thinking about it today or even consider it, a lot of the time we don't consider or think about things that are beneficial to us until it's too late. So I'm saying it right now that you should buy property sooner than later. And what I, second question was, what do I think?
Yeah, how is El Salvador going to be better because you're here?
Oh, I thought it was, what would I have known before I came?
Oh, yeah.
Right.
Yeah,
that was the other way. Yeah. So I was, I should have just invested earlier, but you know, you could always go on with that. But I mean, I think the earlier you would have invested here, just the better off you would have been. I mean, I've been told stories by locals here where they were selling 1 acre lots for $1,000. And I know that sounds crazy, but that's what some people in the United States spend on a dinner on one night.
Mm-hmm.
So by making it better, us here, by being here, we'll make it better by just sharing our culture, sharing our mindset, our philosophy of how business should be made, or business should be transacted, what culture, you know, we're gonna express with the people that are employed by us, but also our clients and the people we'll serve. So it feels like a struggle. It does feel like an uphill battle sometimes, because we've tried to share this knowledge and share this culture with other people, and it's not accepted very quickly, because people really might not recognize it, or they might see you as a foreigner. Even though, you know, my parents are from here, they might still see you as someone who's coming from somewhere else that has more capabilities or is more privileged than they are. But it's ironic, because I tell a lot of people that are born and raised here that I probably had a tougher life than you had, because I look at them and they're just laying down in their hammock all day and they're just grabbing mangoes from their trees, and I never had that privilege. So I've actually had to sleep on wooden floors, I've had cold winters, I've had days where I didn't have food, I've actually had to use a styrofoam cooler as a refrigerator. So I've had it pretty tough. So what I do recommend here is to just keep in mind the culture difference, and that we are, you know, if we're coming from a place where we're more culturally diverse, it is our duty here to share that knowledge and share that wisdom and love with everybody that we come in contact with.
Did you have any other contacts when you came down here? Did you have like abuelos or tios or primos? Did you have people that you could trust?
Not really, no.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And that's one of the big reasons of why I make these videos, is because, and that's why we started Living Like a Local, is because when you come down here, if you don't know the culture, then you can get scammed like that.
Yeah. And, I mean, yeah, it's true. Like my own family tried to scam me.
Yeah.
So it's just the truth. You know, it's just life. It's reality. And I think the sooner in life we face our shadows and our realities, the more prepared we can be and make the right decisions later.
Yeah.
So yeah, I mean, we made a lot of changes in mindset in the year that we've been here, and what you're saying is true. It's correct. Yeah.
Yeah. So if you are thinking about coming back to El Salvador and are thinking about making that big jump, check out Living Like a Local, because they are honest, they are dependable, and they understand the shift that you are about to make. Check out Cargum Raíces Buenas if you are looking for property and you would like to come and make El Salvador your home. That's it. I'm Jenny Adi, shining my light so you can shine yours. I'll see you guys next time. Adios.